Hello students, today we will start with a new poem, poem 2.5, Autumn. Now what is autumn? Autumn is a season. Yes, how we have summer, winter, monsoon, like that autumn also is a season. Now it is a season where you will see the leaves falling from the trees. Yes, the season changes. It is like a mid-season. First, changing from one season to another. Now, on page 49, we will see the warming up year. What changes do you see in nature each of the following season? Yes, a few sentences are given below as examples. Use these on your own and describe a season appropriately. New grass sprouts, of course, we see it in monsoon. Now, we see the mist in the morning. It is in winter. Tender leaves shoot out on plants or trees. It is spring. There are sudden showers and hailstorms. Of course, it is in monsoon. Migratory birds return. Winter. The sun shines brighter than before. Summer. Trees blossom. Spring. Okay. Now, going to the activity 1A. Name six season according to the Indian calendar, which of the season is equivalent to autumn. Now students, this is for self-study. You have to find it out. What changes do we see in the life of human beings when the season changes? With reference to their clothes, diet, celebrations. Okay, so that also is for self-study and it is, you can do it on your own. Now activity 2, I will do it with you all. Guess what is personified? Now personify, you know, personification is a figure of speech, okay, which gives us a human quality to something that is non-living or inanimate. And fill in the gaps. Choose from the brackets. Okay, now going to A1. The weary car was also petrol hungry. So, car being hungry is given a human quality. That's why it's personified. The playful wind whistle among the trees. So, wind is playful. Given again human quality. The annoying alarm screamed at 5 a.m. Annoying alarm. So, annoying, a person can be annoying, not an alarm. The naughty stars. Now, stars are given a quality of human quality of being naughty. Winked at me from above. The rising sun stretched its arm. Again, sun is given human quality of stretching its arms. The cheerful bird sang as it perched on a tree. Bird is given human quality of being cheerful. The tireless machine hummed as it worked hard. Now, tireless machine. The machine is given a human quality of working hard. Now, going to the poem, Autumn. The autumn comes a maiden fair. Now the autumn is given a quality of being a maiden. Maiden means an unmarried girl. Yes, an unmarried girl, young girl, fair. In slenderness and grace. So beautiful, slender and graceful. With nodding rice stems in her hair. And over that she is autumn is personified as being a maiden and she has rice stems in her hair and lilies in her face. There are lilies, the brightness of lilies in her face. In flowers of grasses she is clad. So she is clad means she is dressed. Now what do you mean by clad? Dressed. Okay, and she is dressed with what? Flowers of grasses. She is dressed. And she moves, and as she moves along, birds greet her with their cooing glad. Yes, as autumn moves, the birds keep on greeting her. Yes, greeting her, cheering her, as with gladness, with glad voices. Like a bracelet's tinkling song, and she is greeted with like a bracelet's. Bracelets, you know what is bracelet? Yes, the bracelets that you wear in your wrist. Tinkling song, okay? A diadem adorns the night sky. Diadem means a crown. Yes, a crown of what? Stars. Adorns. Adorns means decorates. The night of multitudinous stars. Multitudinous means numerous, plenty, innumerable stars. Her silken robe is white moonlight. And her robe, her dress is white moonlight. Yes, very bright moonlight. Set free from cloudy bars. And there are no clouds to cover the moon. So the moonlight is pure and very silken white. And there are no clouds covering it. And on her face, the radiant moon, the bright moon is shining directly on her face. Bewitching smiles are shown. Bewitching means very attractive. She is attractive, attracting people with her smiles. Bewitching. Are shown. She seems a slender maid. She seems a very slim maid, not fat, not bulky, but very slim and beautiful and graceful maid. Maid means who? Unmarried girl who soon will be a woman grown, who will soon step up to become a woman. Okay, so this way the poem, the poet Kalidas, yes, has written the poem. Actually, it was written in Sanskrit and it is translated into English by Professor A.W. Ryder. Okay, so you know Kalidas, a Sanskrit poet of our ancient times, writing many poems and especially about nature. So here he has personified autumn, a season, in such a beautiful way, comparing autumn to a very beautiful girl, yes, a maiden, an unmarried girl with beautiful, clad in good, nice costumes of the nature. Okay, so now students, we will go with the figures of speech. Okay, take pencils in your hand. The autumn comes a maiden fair, metaphor. Why metaphor? Because autumn is indirectly compared to a maiden fair. In slenderness and grace, with nodding rice stems in her hair, its personification, and the autumn is given a human quality of having hair, yes, and lilies in her face, again personification, because if you go to see, the full poem is personified. In flowers of grasses she is clad, again personification, as she moves along. Birds greet her with their cooing glad. Okay, so it is onomatopoeia. Why onomatopoeia? Sound is expressed with the word cooing, like bracelets tinkling song. So it is simile. A diadem adorns the night, exclamation, of multitudinous stars. Her silken robe is white moonlight. Again, metaphor, because her silken robe is indirectly compared to white moonlight. Set free from cloudy bars, and on her face, the radiant moon. Again, the autumn, which is compared to a maiden, is given a human quality of having a face. So it is personification. Bewitching smiles are shown, attractive smiles. So again, it is personification. She seems a slender maid who soon. Now this is alliteration because sound of S is repeated. She seems a slender maid who soon will be a woman grown. So students, you can put it, these two last two lines will be climax. Why climax? Because it is put in ascending order. Okay, so this poem is very beautifully written and very poetically. Now going to the workshop. Okay, now the first activity is self-study. Now pick out words from the poem to describe. So this also is self-study. So students, you have to do it on your own because everything is explained in the poem. Yes, and you can write it, like for example, the first one is given to you. द ऑटम अ मेडन फेयर स्टार्स अ डियडम ऑफ मल्टीट्यूडनस स्टार्स मूनलाइट सिल्क एंड वाइट इज कंपेयर्ड टू सिल्क एंड वाइट कूइंग ऑफ बर्ड्स इज अगेन गिवन द क्वालिटी कंपेयर्ड टू ब्रेसलेट्स टिंकलिंग साउंड ओके देन एक्टिविटी थ्री also you have to find you can do it because I have already given you all the figures of speech write the rhyme scheme of the poem yes we can do it later on or you can find it out think and write in your own words this is omitted sixth is omitted okay and the remaining activities are omitted okay